Now, our theme this year is Venetian Carnival. The Italians know how to celebrate. See, again, once again, me being Italian myself, believe me, I know all about it firsthand. In fact, I still have relatives in Italy. Now, I thought this would be really fun and really cool. Since no one got to travel this past year, it might be fun to give you all a brief tour of Italy before the show begins. And like I said, I happen to have four cousins who live in four different cities in Italy who have agreed to Zoom in via satellite with me and you. Now, they are sisters, my cousins, and they're all, in fact, quadruplets. Could you believe that? I can, because it runs in our family. My father has an identical twin, and there's the quadruplets, and, well, I guess it just sort of stops there. First, let's check in with my cousin Viviana in Naples. Viviana, buonasera. Good to see you.
Tommaso, come stai? Look at you, my little cucino. What
hey.
Happened to your hair?
Oh,
never
highlights.
Mind. I don't want to know. Oh. Ciao, everybody in Florida. Hey? It's so nice of you to help raise money for the children. Tommaso, why didn't you come to visit me when you were in Italy 3 years ago?
I don't.
Giuseppe, he was so disappointed.
I can't hear
How
you.
How your mama and papa? Your mama Isabella is beautiful as ever. And your papa? He's not so nice.
No, my father's very nice, and my mother and father are doing really well, and they're surviving these difficult times. Oh. I hope you two are staying safe. Sure. But you know what? I thought it'd be fun if the viewing audience heard a little bit more about Naples. Tell us.
Si. Most people call Rome the heart of Italy.
Yes.
But I say Napoli is the soul, because it's shaped like a boot. You get it? The soul? I feel like a heel. To get the true Italiano experience, you come to Naples, stand on the hills, and see the magnificent view of the Mediterranean Sea. You know, our history dates back before the Greeks. And of course, we are famous for Napolitana pastry.
Oh, they're my favorite.
Which reminds me, why do you look so skinny? Don't they feed you in America? Are you on a fatty diet?
Yeah, I work out, Viviana. Get back to the pizza.
So need to eat more pizza.
I love pizza.
Pizza, she was invented here in Napoli. Maybe you didn't know.
I didn't.
But every year, in September, we have a big pizza fest, except not this September, and you know why, huh?
Yeah, the great pizza dough famine of 2020, but get back to the pizza.
Chefs from Italy and all over the world come to make hundreds of different kinds of a pizza. Well, there's parties, entertainment, and then you vote for the best pizza. Wait a minute. You should have a pizza fest next year for your big gala. You will raise a lot of dough. I did it again.
Two in one session. That's amazing. You're hilarious. Huh? And you're one of my favorite cousins.
Oh.
You know, hey, I will mention it to the team about your Pizza Fest idea and also give my best to Giuseppe.
He tonight works on Central Funicular.
What? The
Funicular. It's a cable car that goes up and down in the hills. Tomasa.
Oh, yeah.
Funicular.
Ciao, la, la. I will. Ciao.
Ciao.
Bye, baby.
Ciao.
Wow. I hope you enjoyed Viviana, and I hope you enjoyed that segment with a brief visit to Naples as much as I did. Who knew what a funicular was? It's amazing. We knew the song, but I didn't know it was one of those cable cars. But let's continue with our excursion through Italy. I have another cousin. We're going to Pisa with my cousin Domenica. Domenica, hey!
Ciao.
Hey.
Tommaso, where are you? I can hear you. I can see you.
I'm in Orlando.
There you are. You're so tiny on the little screen. What happened to your hair?
Highlights.
I don't want to know.
Hey, how are things in Pisa? My guests are wondering all about that Leaning Tower.
You know she was started in 1170, but they stopped building her after three stories because everybody went off to fight a war.
What?
Kind of like me. I start something, I get distracted, I can't finish it. And then my mama, she said, Domenica, you're never going to find a husband if you can't concentrate.
Domenica, let's get back to the tower, honey. Let's go.
They come back from war.
Yeah.
And look what they find. The tower, she's a leaning to one side.
Yeah.
It turns out they built on a soft soil, kind of like my heart. She's too soft. So they build the next three stories with a little bit more weight.
Yeah.
And guess what?
What?
Boom, bada, bing.
Ow.
She leans to the other side.
Oh,
she
boy.
Doesn't know which way to go, to this side, to that side, kind of like me. I meet a molto bello man. He's a baker. Do I like him? I don't like him. He says to me, Domina, what does Darth Vader order in an Italian bakery?
Oh, I don't know. What does Darth Vader order in an Italian bakery?
Only one cannoli.
Good one.
I don't get it.
I got it.
And I say, Mama mia, when am I going to find a man to marry?
Hey, Okay, the I'm tower. Changing to the subject, Domenica, focus. Are there bells in the tower?
There are seven bells in the tower. One for each of the major scale, you know. Do, re, mi, fa,
don't
sol.
Sing, non che sing.
No,
hey, do they ring the bells?
Oh, no, no, no. Tommaso, no,
oh, my
no,
God,
no.
Don't yell.
They never, never ring the bell.
Why? They're Why don't
afraid.
They ring the bells?
They're afraid the vibrations, it will make the Pisa Tower fall over. Just like my love life.
Oh boy.
She fell over. Nobody ringing my bell.
Yeah, no one's going to ring
so
your bell.
Lonely.
All right. Hey, Domenico, it's
Please
great talking to you.
Don't leave me.
Yeah, yeah.
Ray
Domenico, hey, ciao.
Ciao.
We'll call you later.
Ciao, ciao.
Gotta go.
Ciao.
Gotta go. God, hey. Hey, folks. Domenico could be a little intense. You know, every time I talk to her, I feel like, woo, boy, do I need a drink. My, Delilah. That is a good cocktail. This is nice. Get off your couch and go make a Delilah. Thanks, Indy. Hey, let's continue with our visit around Rome. I have another cousin. She's in Roma, and her name is Enrica. Enrica, buonasera.
Ciao, buonasera, Tommaso.
Hey.
Right on time, perfecto. What happened to your hair?
It's highlights.
Don't tell me, I don't
want to
know.
Anybody in Italy have highlights?
Ciao, everybody in Florida. Welcome to the eternal city of Rome. I'm so happy to join you. I only have a few minutes. What can I do
okay.
for you?
Yeah, we're in a rush. So but Rome is an amazing city. Tell us a flavor of Rome.
Oh, everybody knows the great history of Rome.
Yeah.
The empire that stretched the entire Mediterranean and beyond.
Toilets.
The great system of roads, the
indoor
Colosseum,
toilets.
You say behind me, the Roman Forum. Now, I live in a central storico, the history section.
I remember.
Rome. You know, Tom, you came to visit me at my house. Yeah. Next time you're going to stay in my house. Remember, we walked the cobblestone streets. We went to Trevi Fountain, a Spanish steps, the Pantheon.
Yeah, we walked and walked.
Well,
and walked.
You wouldn't get on my Vespa.
What? And you're crazy driving around. Well, you're like Batgirl.
You're such a scary cat, a fofone. You're going to scare people back into wearing chino pants. Hey, we forgot to talk about Piazza Square. You know, St. Peter's Square. It's not Rome, it's Vatican City.
Yeah, beautiful.
But still part of Rome. Oh, St. Peter's Square. When you see the artwork alone, it will overwhelm you.
I know, beautiful.
And the Sistina Chapel, since they cleaned the ceiling, more spectacular than ever.
Yes, and thank you for giving that private tour. It was amazing. I really appreciate it.
Oh, the other wonderful thing about Roma is the cuisine.
Yes.
Next time you come to Rome, you're going to stay in my house. I'm going to take you to that restaurant, La Pergola. Three
Michelin
stars. You
remember? I read about it.
Hey, listen, the water menu, 45 choices. Wine list, over 70,000 bottles.
45 choices of water. I wouldn't know where to start. Enrica, thank you for giving us this brief taste of Rome. I'm sorry we don't have more time.
Listen, it's been my pleasure. By the way, have you spoken to Mia Sorella, my sister?
Of course. We've talked to Viviana. We've talked to Domenica. Mm. And Angelina's next. Angelina in Venice is next.
Listen, Domenica, she pazzo, cucu friazzo. She
Tell
drives me crazy. Angelina, she's an angel. Mm. And Viviana, I visit every year in September for the pizza fest, but not this past September. Because you know why.
The
hey, next year, you should probably have a pizza fest for your gala. It'll be a real slice. Ciao.
That's what she said. Okay, see you later. Okay. Now, our Venetian Carnival is just moments away. And if you're just tuning in, I've been taking our guests on a little tour of Italy via my four cousins, female, and their quadruplets. Let's go right now to Venice to see Angelina. Angelina!
Ciao, Tommaso! Good to see you!
Hey.
Oh, what did you do to your hair?
Nothing.
I love it.
Thank you.
Ciao, everybody in Florida. I hope you're all having a wonderful carnival!
We are! We're going to have the official carnival in just a few minutes,
Perfecto.
But I thought perhaps you could tell us a little bit of the background about the carnival in Venice.
Oh, she started back in 1162, which is the amount of weight I gained this year. St. Mark's Square is where everybody used to gather to sing, dance, and celebrate military victory. And over the years, it grew into masks and costumes. But from time to time, it was a band because things got out of hand. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I think I know. I'm Italian. Yeah. I think we know how to have a good time in the streets.
I will never tell anybody about that teeny tiny bikini bottom
that you wore. The carnival. When did it start?
Well, the carnival, as we know today, started in 1979.
The year I was born.
You wish.
Yeah.
It has grown into a big, international international event. Yeah. 500,000 people come to Venice, and masks have become a very high art form. There are masquerade balls, masquerade gondola parades, elaborate masquerade parties, and La Maschera Più Bella, the most beautiful mask competition.
Wow.
And I understand some of your students you're going to help tonight have made masks. I'm sure they're beautiful and worthy of your support.
Yeah, our beautiful set is decorated with some of their work, and the creation of their masks are really pretty. Mm-hmm. But tell us more about the city of Venice. I bet it's like no other place in the world.
You took the words right out of my mouth.
I know.
This city was built on 118 islands.
What?
118 islands.
No, I heard you. I just couldn't believe it.
Separated by 150 canals. You know there are no cars in Venice.
I didn't.
You can only go by boat, and of course, a gondola.
The gondolas, since there's no cars, there must be like 100 billion million gondolas.
No, there are only 400 gondolas in all of Venice. It's very difficult to become a gondolier.
What?
It pays very well.
Oh.
You have to study and train for 6 months.
Six?
And the exam is very difficult to pass. My sweet Giovanni is a gondolier.
Oh, he is? Ooh. Oh, did he Venezia you off your feet, Sia?
No, we met in line for confession.
Oh, he's a sinner.
Aren't we all?
Yes.
Listen, Tommaso, there is nothing more romantic than a nighttime gondola ride through the canals of Venice, especially when your gondolier begins to sing. You are transported into another world. It overwhelms your heart as you float on the music of a love.
Oh, Angelina. Will you leave us with a beautiful image? Grazie, grazie,
you're
an angel. They should make you a saint.
Prego mio cugino, and may all of you find the love in your hearts tonight to give what you can. Ciao, Tommaso.
Angelina, such a lovely girl. And yes, please try to give all you can. And I'm sure that our Venetian carnival will inspire the love for UCP that a gondola ride through the canals in Venice inspires in romantic love.